What will Satan do when the wicked are raised? He's desperate now. It never fails to amaze me how he responds. Instead of the devil repenting, we got a question in tonight. People feel sorry for the devil. They say, if Lucifer repented, will God forgive him? Some people are so loving. And you know, I bless your heart, I love people like that. They want everyone to be saved. It's like this guy I heard about worked in an office, and he worked with some office mate. This lady was just always blowing sunshine all the time. She was just happy, pop, bubbly, carbonated all the time. He'd walk and say, oh man, the rain out there, it's cold, miserable. She'd, oh, but the flowers will be so nice. And you know, she was always so positive. It used to irritate him. So she's just not in touch. He knew she was a Christian, so he went to the office one day and said, boy, that devil, isn't he bad? She said, oh, he's just busy. He's positive all the time. So it says, the devil shall go out to deceive the nations that are in the four quarters of the earth, Gog and Magog. Now people wonder, who are Gog and Magog? And they try to say, this represents Russia. Well, it is true that you first find in Genesis chapter 10 reference to Magog. And there were these people that they believed descended. Josephus says that they were the Scythians that lived in the north and the east up in that country north of Israel. They were enemies of God's people, long time historic enemies of God's people. Gog and Magog means from the matrix of God. I learned that from a professor here at Andrews. Magog means Gog, these enemies of God's people and their descendants. It's like Babylon and her daughters is what it's saying. It's talking simply about the enemies of God's people. The wicked are all raised. That's Gog and Magog. People are trying to say, is that Russia? Is it China? What nation is this that's going to? It's just the wicked. This is, remember the names in Revelation, this will help you. The names in Revelation are generally symbolic. It talks about dragon, it talks about Egypt, it talks about Pharaoh, Balaam, Jezebel. And it's taking Old Testament stories and characters to teach truth. Gog and Magog go to the Old Testament. They were enemies of God's people. It doesn't mean he's going to resurrect this extinct nation. Okay? And they went up on the breadth of the earth and compassed the camp of the saints. That's the New Jerusalem, the beloved city. And it tells us that fire comes down from God out of heaven and devours them. Now, before that happens, when they surround the city of God, just to give you a little picture, there is an episode that we insert here. It's called the Great White Throne Judgment. You know, there's an amazing fact from history I thought might fit in here. Napoleon Bonaparte, for a 10-year period, he was basically fighting on every front of Europe. And for a while there, it looked like he was going to regain the territory of the ancient Roman Empire. But he abdicated, was sent off to Ebla. And for just about a year, he was held a prisoner in this island. He managed to escape, and he staged a brief 100-day comeback. And you know what happened during that 100-day comeback? He showed that he hadn't changed. Finally, he was permanently defeated at Waterloo, sent to St. Helena, died there. Sort of reminds me of what's happening to the devil. The devil makes an attempt for a brief comeback. After 1,000 years, does the devil repent for his sins? Or does he try to rally all the wicked to fight against the city of God? And at the point, and we don't know how long this period is where they muster their forces to fight against the city of God, but just before that happens, Christ and the Father, I believe, ascend up above the city. This is where the great white throne judgment takes place.